Hi guys, Story Recaps here. Today I am going to entertain you with a 2013 sci-fi action film called The Colony. Spoilers ahead, enjoy and take care. The new ice age has frozen the earth and driven the remains of civilization underground. An alarm rings through the halls of one of the last remaining outposts. When two of the individuals hear distant cries, they run. They make their way to a hatch and beg to be let in. There is a second outpost visible. A guy is working on one of the satellite dishes when the hatch opens and three men appear. One of them begs for one more day to live, but Mason isn't prepared to take that risk because the man's illness is worsening and he doesn't believe he'll recover. The man accepts his fate and opts for the walk rather than being shot. Mason refuses to acknowledge his right to do so. Sam joins them and informs them that the man has a choice, but Mason feels he will return to the colony, as the sick typically do. The two argue, but as the guy attempts to escape, Mason shoots him dead. Living in the restricted area of the outpost has turned the ordinary cold into a dangerous enemy for the survivors, who are fearful of an outbreak at any moment. For that reason, they created a set of rules to battle it. First, the sick person is quarantined, but if they don't get any better, they can choose between a bullet and a long walk in the snow. Sam's outpost is one of the few sites where life may persist beneath the ice, where seeds can be kept and food can be grown. People flock to such locations, but their numbers rapidly declined. Some of them believe in fantastical heaven with a blue sky. Sam, on the other hand, does not believe such stories. In addition, he is more terrified of other people than he is of the virus. Briggs suddenly goes by, and Sam follows. Briggs knows precisely what he's going to say and informs him that the man's blood test showed positive and that he had to die. Sam informs him that Mason did not respect the man's wish to take the walk, which causes Briggs to stop. He doesn't like that either, but he tells Sam that they have a bigger issue to worry about. They go into the communications room, and Cooper tells them that Colony 5 hasn't replied to any of his calls, even though they've sent them a distress message. Briggs instructs Cooper on what to do next and dispatches Sam to assist Victor with the livestock. Cooper makes an announcement as he approaches him, notifying everyone that a general assembly will be held in the hall in half an hour. When he walks in, he wonders if he'll be able to save the rabbits. The previous litter was stillborn, and only one of the 12 remaining is female. The others are unwilling to mate. Meanwhile, Briggs travels to speak with him about the man he shot. He's unhappy because he didn't offer him an option. Mason replies that it was him that gave him the job, so he asks for the opportunity to do it, with a little more respect from Briggs because they have history. Kai is working and hears Sam come in. She tells him that he didn't scare her and they kiss. He informs her that he requires pellets for the rabbits and, while she searches for them, he inquires about the project she is working on. Kai believes she can locate workable weather manipulation technology, which she hopes will help them escape the ice age. Sam dislikes the thought of using the technology again, but requests that she bring him with her when she finds it. They leave in order to get on time for the meeting. Everyone is gathering in the hall. Before Sam approaches a couple, the man Dexter tells his wife not to cough. Sam speaks to him, but notices that they're not feeling well, and suggests that they go back to their room. Briggs walks in as the meeting is about to start, when he suddenly catches a kid stealing his lighter. He tells everyone about the issue with Colony 5, and considering that another colony was closed down the previous year, Briggs thinks it is important to check in on them. He instructs Cooper to check how many radio components he has to spare, then asking for two volunteers for the team he's building together. Mason feels they should not spare anything or anyone, given the possibility that the colony has been infected with the flu. Reynolds backs him up, but Kai says they have to care about each other. Briggs asks Dexter to join the team when Sam volunteers in his stead, saying he's needed there. Victor's son Graydon also volunteers, to the displeasure of his parents. Briggs accepts both volunteers, and places Kai in charge of the colony until he gets back. Dexter's wife coughs and scares everyone away from the meeting. Briggs gives Mason a glance, and they take the couple to quarantine. He tells Dexter that they should have spoken out earlier. Mason wants to give them the test right away, but Briggs tells him to wait until he returns. In the meanwhile, he says he should talk with Kai, but Mason doubts she'll be able to make the big decision. Sam has a nightmare that he's lost in the snow as a boy and finds his mother dead. He wakes up. Kai walks up to him as he tells her about it and she says that it's not his fault. She is concerned that he is going and tells that he returned to her. The team is departing the safety of the colony the next day. They make their way across a freezing and abandoned city. They arrive at one of the weather manipulation devices. Graydon wonders if it still works, but Briggs tells him that it was damaged a long time ago. They continue their walk over the frozen environment, arriving at a bridge and wondering if it is safe to cross. Slowly navigating between the gaps, they reach a bigger one which they would have to cross by a dangerous path. Briggs has a near call, but they make it. Graydon notices a car on the bridge as he gets to the opposite side. A man appears to be seated next to it. They go cautiously toward it, and when they approach, they discover that the guy had shot himself as well as his wife. Briggs keeps them pushing ahead, despite the fact that they have no idea why the man is out there. They come to a wrecked helicopter in the middle of their journey, which is usually utilized as a shelter during such journeys. Briggs calls their colony to inform them of their progress. Cooper informs him that Dexter and his wife are getting worse. Mason insists on giving them the test. Briggs authorizes Cooper to use force against Mason if he crosses another boundary. Following the call, Briggs informs Sam that the helicopter is near to where he found him. Sam explains how he got there to Graydon. When his party of survivors ran out of supplies, the men traveled to the city to seek assistance and never returned. When people began to die in their refuge, he was determined to get his mother and sister out. They went out looking for a better place, but got hit by a storm. He was the sole survivor, only because Briggs had found him. They arrive at the outskirts of Colony 5 the next day. As they get closer to the door, they notice blood on the snow and smell smoke from inside. Briggs enters first as the other two wait outside for him. Graydon is afraid to walk inside, but Sam assures him that they must remain together. There's more blood inside. Sam inquires as to how many were left the last time Briggs was there, and he is informed that there were 50. They proceed farther inside the colony outpost, seeing more blood on the ground. Briggs hands Graydon a gun. Quietly sneaking through the outpost, they see it's completely trashed and spattered with more blood all over. The boy comments that all of the people must be dead, when they hear noises in the distance. They follow the banging, thinking that someone might be alive. Sam rushes forward to investigate the source of the noise. They arrive at a door that appears to have suffered a pounding. Briggs goes first after he opens it. They see someone inside and believe he is dead. He leaps up and terrifies them as they move closer to him. The man, clearly terrified, tries to fight them off. They inform him that they are there to help him. He asks if they're gone and tells them to lock the door. Sam gives him some water, and the man introduces himself as Leland. He also asks for some food as they keep questioning him. Leland is unsure how long he was in the room, or if anyone else is alive. Briggs claims that they received their distress signal and came to assist. The guy informs them that they restored the antenna and gained incredible range from it. His colony only received a fraction of the transmission. A guy is seen in a video telling how they rebuilt one of the weather machines, and successfully melted the permafrost, reaching fertile land. They simply require someone to bring them seeds to plant. The communication just transmits a fraction of their location. Leland tells them that they sent a team to find the source of the message, but never found the people. Someone tracked down the colony's crew and followed them. When Briggs informs him that they'll take him back with them, he shows Sam the spot where they've triangulated the message. Leland is terrified of leaving the room. Sam assures him that there is no one outside, and that they were aware of his presence due to the knocking. But, he says, he wasn't the one knocking. Briggs orders Graydon to call their colony, and Sam to take anything they can carry back. He finds explosives in one of the drawers, and is informed by the youngster that the colony is not answering. Briggs said they'll radio again when they return to the topside. They are about to depart when they hear a horrific noise outside. Briggs checks it out, but when he doesn't see anything around, he tells the others to get Leland and get moving. The four of them leave the room when Leland escapes Graydon's grasp, gets back inside and locks the door. The other three go through the corridors of the outpost and keep hearing more banging and screaming. They can hear someone moving behind a curtain farther within the station. Graydon believes they shouldn't be there, so they turn out all of their lights. They enter a bloodbath as they go closer to the sound. In the midst of the chaos, one man is butchering a body, another is eating on one, and a third is shaping his teeth. The colonists have all been killed. The butcher smells them, and turns around, but Sam gets him. More awaken from the pile of dead bodies and get ready to go after the three men. They run when Sam shoots the cannibal boss. The cannibals instantly follow them. Briggs releases a dynamite stick, but only receives a few. Graydon rushes forward and is caught by two cannibals who immediately attack him. Briggs and Sam come to his aid shooting at the cannibals, but more start showing up. They manage fight them off, but there's nothing they can do for Graydon. The two of them keep running. Sam fires another round and runs out of ammunition. Briggs stands back and destroys the stairs before the cannibals can reach them. Suddenly, another one appears on his level. They fight, but Briggs also grabs him. The rest of the cannibals arrive and see the damage he has done. When he joins Sam outside, he throws dynamite down the chute, closing the opening to the colony. The two of them run away from the outpost and take the same route home. They eventually make it to the chopper. Sam feels they should keep traveling to their colony, but Briggs says they won't reach it because the temperature is lowering too quickly. Later that night, Sam inquires about the cannibals with Briggs. He warns him that in order to live, people would do awful things. Briggs tells him a story from the army about something that happened during the relief operation. He'd seen people lose control and go feral, with nothing human left in them. During the relief, Briggs found himself in a situation where he saw people turn on each other the same way as the cannibals. He and Mason had left the refuge, hoping to find a location where nothing like that could occur. When Sam recalls the transmission, Briggs informs him that they'll look for it when they return since they have seeds ready to plant. Sam notices the cannibals' footsteps leading to the helicopter the next day. He is concerned that they will lead them back to the colony, but Briggs thinks they can stop them at the bridge. They head for it fast, with the cannibals right on their trail. Once on the bridge, they continue running and jump the giant gap, then Briggs takes out the dynamite, ready to blow it out. He places the explosives at the gap and they leave, but the fuse breaks. Briggs knocks him out when Sam refuses to let him go to ignite it again. The cannibals are getting closer, and the wind prevents him from lighting the fuse again. A few get close, but they fall through the gap. Briggs ultimately blows the fuse and challenges them to approach him. When the dynamite bursts in his hands, leaving a big hole in the bridge. The leader is still alive and he sees Sam on the other side. Sam continues to run toward the outpost by himself. He passes by the weather machine and eventually gets to the outpost. Meanwhile, Mason and Reynolds have taken Dexter and his wife outdoors, ignoring his demands to administer the test to her. Mason shoots her and declares that no further experiments will be conducted. Kai walks outside with them and aims her rifle at him. When they hear Sam pleading for aid, he wants things to alter in his favor at the colony. Kai pursues Sam, and Dexter escapes. When she reaches Sam, Mason comes up behind her and knocks her over. Later, Sam wakes up and two women are standing over him, telling him that he's safe. He was out for a few hours. When Victor inquires about his son, Sam informs him that both he and Briggs have died. Mason enters and cuffs him to the bed, informing him of a change in authority. He claims that meals would be slashed in half, and that everyone who appears ill will be examined right away. Sam tells them what occurred in Colony 5 and about the cannibals that followed them out. He also informs them about the message, but Mason is skeptical and leaves. The little thief gives Sam the keys to the cuffs. Victor and Mason check for the cannibals outside. Then they check the monitors, but find nothing. Reynolds enters and tells him of Sam's escape, prompting them to chase him. Meanwhile, Sam discovers Kai, who is chained and in pain. He lets her go, and they head to her computer so Sam can show her where the message came from. It takes him a long to discover it, but he ultimately does. Sam gathers some of the seeds, and they both rush out of the vault to inform the others of the message. Mason catches them and tells them that no one is leaving. Suddenly, there's a banging noise outside. They go to check the monitors and see the cannibals storming the doors, trying to take them down. The leader holds out Dexter's severed head to the camera, then breaks it. Mason orders that everyone who can shoot be given a gun and that everyone who can't be sent to the vault. When Cooper hears running on the floor above, he helps the individuals within the vault. The lights go out for a second while the colonists wait for the cannibals to burst through the doors. The doors swing open, but no one comes in. More noise can be heard from somewhere inside the shelter. Suddenly, cannibals burst out of the vents inside the shelter and attack Cooper, then go after the people in the vault. Fortunately, one of the kids is quick enough to seal the hatch. Meanwhile, Sam and the others discover they're inside, crawling in the vents as they start bursting out of them. They battle off a couple of them, but more come. Victor faces up against the leader, as Sam and Kai try to hold the others at bay while fleeing to a safe place. Victor is finally killed by the leader. Meanwhile, Mason escapes to a safe room, but closes the door in front of Sam's and Kai's face. The woman inside knocks Mason out and opens the door for them. They reseal the door in time to keep the incoming cannibals out, but since the door won't hold for long, Sam shows them a path that leads to the surface. Except for Mason, Sam unlocks the vent and they all crawl inside. He throws a gun at him, and as he aims it at him, Sam says he'll need every bullet he can get and dives inside the vent. The cannibals knock down the door, and when Mason sees them enter the chamber, he blasts a tank of gas, blowing them all up. The leader is able to save himself by jumping into the vent. When he approaches Sam, they battle within the vent before falling through it into another area. They continue to struggle there, until the leader has the upper hand on Sam and starts pounding him down. He tells him that he wants more. At one point, Sam gets control over the fight and starts to savagely hit the leader. Eventually, he cuts his head off. The last survivors make it outside the outpost and find it burning on the inside. Sam appears at the door. He meets them and informs them that they must proceed to the place specified in the message. The survivors pay attention to him and begin their hard journey across the ice and snow. They only have one guideline to follow out there. Survive. Subscribe and turn on the notifications. We daily upload videos like this.